My name is Trisha Lee. This is my story. What will you do?
My name is Jared Braybrook. This is my story. What will you do?
My name is Freddie Hamilton. This is my story. What will you do?
My name is Alicia Seo. This is my story. What will you do?
I graduated in 2006, came back for a victory lap in 2007.
And I'm from the class of 2010.
Graduated in 2010.
I graduated in the class of 2011.
I'm a second year psychology student at Brock University.
Right now I'm an apprentice for Hydro One as a powerline technician. However, I just recently retired from the Canadian Forces.
I'm going to Brock University part-time, take a few courses here and there, and continue to play hockey for the Niagara Ice Dogs.
I'm currently studying at Carleton University in Ottawa, and I'm going for my Bachelor of Public Affairs and Policy Management.
12 when I found out that I had gotten the Excellence in Education Award. For me, that was probably the most pivotal because in a way it had solidified all my hard work in high school, and it really made me feel like I was doing something right, and that when I move on, I could move on with confidence that I had the skills and the skill set that had got me to that point and to move on and continue.
Me when I was in high school was playing football. I was kind of going in a nowhere direction, and I was approached and asked if I would like to try for the team, and I did that, and it brought me a lot more self-worth and a lot more team-oriented outlook on life.
I think it was when I walked into Mr. Carr's room in grade 11 and they told me I won student council president, and I was super happy, and I remember jumping up and down, and I remember like staying at school from like 8 a.m. until like 10 p.m. at night for student council, but I really loved it and it taught me to be a leader. It comes around again,
I say only. My absolute favorite memory is the fact that here at Simcoe, the teachers really are willing to be personal on a one-on-one basis with you. They're not here to just do their job, they're here to go beyond that.
During game weeks, you know, we'd all get together the day before a game, we're all in our jerseys. The day of a game, we'd all be in our suits, you know, looking all spiff. And it was always, you know, we always turned a head or two when we were walking down the hall, so it was pretty cool.
The teachers are all helpful and nice, and the students are all nice and including too, so it was a lot of fun to go here.
The first time I watched Lockdown go on stage, I was stage manager, and I didn't think it was possible that we could get a play done in 3 weeks. But the first time I was up in the booth and watching the play, I felt incredibly proud that I managed to do something like this.
One of my challenges was time management. Had a very busy time in hockey and didn't have a lot of time to necessarily do a lot of school outside of school, and a lot of road trips and things like that when we were away. So. It was definitely hard to try to do well in both at the same time.
From grade 6 to 8, I had been the kid with cancer. So for me, coming to high school, it was a clean slate for me. There was only a seldom handful of people who actually knew what I had been through. And not that I was ashamed of it, but it was just a new dynamic for me, learning how to deal with it myself, having been through my treatment and had completed it.
In my early high school years, I wasn't very outgoing. I kind of, you know, I'd have my friends, but I really stuck to myself. Didn't really do much as for the school. After I started playing ball and in my later years, you know, I really became more open to a lot of different things that the school had to offer. And that was probably one of my biggest challenges, getting over my shyness, I guess you could say.
My biggest lesson that I learned in high school would probably be to take all the opportunities that you can. Because you never know where it's going to lead you to or what you're going to discover about yourself. Prior to coming into high school, I loved drama, like watching it and doing it, but I never had the interest into the backstage part. And then someone took an interest in me, and all of a sudden I fell in love with being a stage manager and learning those skills, and that was something I probably would have never known if someone hadn't taken an interest in me and said, look, you have these skills and this is what you can do that I never knew how to do.
You know, tell myself, tough times never last, but tough people do, right? You might be having a bad day, but it's not gonna last forever. you know, what does last forever is that, you know, you have the ability to pick up your socks and carry on with what you have to do.
And as you can see from the our host faces, or the faces of Governor Simcoe, we have students that graduate from this school and go on to just do incredible things. And it's because it's our host and it's our school, and we all work together to make it the best school that we can.
98% of our graduating class of 2011 had a confirmed post-secondary placement in the college or university of their choice. We're very excited about that.